In the last video, we talked about the mass and the center of mass of a lamina. In this video, we're going to talk about the moment of inertia. Now, moment of inertia is the thing that's analogous to mass for rotational motion. So, if you think about mass, the energy that you need to move something sideways is proportional to the mass. If you throw a baseball 50 miles an hour, it takes a certain amount of energy. You know, to get a freight train moving at 50 miles an hour, it takes a lot more energy. And in fact, our formula is the kinetic energy is 1/2 times the mass times the velocity squared. So we're thinking of mass as the proportionality constant that goes into this formula for energy. Now, the moment of inertia is the same sort of thing for rotation. It's usually denoted by the letter I, and it's the energy needed to rotate at a given rate. In particular, the formula is that the kinetic energy is 1/2 the moment of inertia times the angular velocity squared. The angular velocity is the rate at which the angle is changing. If theta is the angle, then d theta dt is the angular velocity. So omega equals 3 means you're going around at 3 radians per second. Okay. So the kinetic energy is some constant times omega squared. And that constant is 1/2 the moment of inertia. So it's analogous to mass. Okay, so let's figure out what the moment of inertia is for a single point mass. So here we have a mass on a rod going around and around and around and around. Now, as it goes around, if you had a mass here, it's going to go a certain distance. If the mass was twice as far, it would traverse twice as much distance every revolution. So in particular, the velocity of this mass is proportional to how far it is from the origin. The things that are close to the origin are moving kind of slowly. They take a second to go this short distance. The things that are far away take a second to go a much larger distance. So in fact, the velocity is equal to the distance times the angular velocity. And that means that our kinetic energy is proportional to r squared because it is proportional to velocity squared. Our kinetic energy is 1/2 mv squared, but v is r omega, so that's 1/2 m r squared omega squared. So that tells us what the moment of inertia is of a single mass. It's just the mass times the distance squared. Great. That's for one mass. What if you had a whole collection of masses? So you had 37 different points, and you're rotating all of them. Well, the kinetic energy of those 37 different points is the kinetic energy of the first point, plus the second point, plus the third point, plus the fourth point. The kinetic energy of each point is just 1/2 mr squared omega squared. You add them all up, and that means that this quantity in the middle has to be the moment of inertia of the whole thing. To get the moment of inertia of a bunch of masses, you add up mass times distance squared for all of the points. So now we can turn to our lamina. We look at our little box, we chop it up into boxes, and we say, hey, what about this little box? This little box has mass, density, times area. Well, not exactly, because you have to pick a particular point to represent the density, and the density isn't actually constant, but close enough. And then you multiply by distance squared, and the distance squared is x squared plus y squared. And so the total moment of inertia is going to be the add up of all the boxes, density times x squared plus y squared times delta x delta y, and the limit of a sum as you chop things finer and finer and finer is an integral. So the moment of inertia is given by integrating x squared plus y squared times the density with respect to area over your lamina. So let's work an example. Our example is the one we did looked at before for center of mass. It's the unit square with density equal to x times y. So we just have to do the integral. The integral of x squared plus y squared times the density dA. And our limits of integration are x goes from 0 to 1, y goes from 0 to 1, x squared plus y squared times xy, And dA we're going to write as dx dy. And when you multiply it out, it's just x cubed y plus xy cubed. And each one of those is an easy integral. Integral of x cubed from 0 to 1 is a quarter. Integral of x from 0 to 1 is a half. So you get a quarter of y plus a half of y cubed. And then you integrate that from 0 to 1, and you get 1 eighth plus an eighth equals a quarter. It's just do the darned integral, and you get the darned answer. And that's it.